Ahoj všichni, vítejte u nového videa. Hello everybody and welcome to my new video. Thank you to all of you who participated in the poll, which I posted a couple of days ago. Based on your responses, I chose practical phrases in a dialogue, which got most votes. So I would like to introduce some colloquial Czech in a dialogue. And because today is the 30th of December, only two more days of the year 2021, and tomorrow is the New Year's Eve, I'm going to focus this dialogue on a conversation between people meeting right before New Year's Eve. And before I start, I would just like to point out that if you're a beginner in Czech, or you are thinking of studying Czech with more structure, and you're a beginner, I would like to invite you to check out my new video course. You can find it on the link below the video. And now let's start with our topic. First, I would like to point out the difference between Nový rok and Nový rok. Well, the only difference is the capital letter here. In Czech, we are very peculiar about writing capital letters versus lowercase letters. And there are very specific rules to that. Nový rok with a capital N means just the New Year's Day, which is also considered a holiday. So that would be the New Year's Day, just the 1st of January here in the Czech Republic. Whereas when you spell it with a lowercase N, it means the upcoming year, the New Year. So when you write a message and you say Šťastný nový rok, which means Happy New Year, it should be with a lowercase n, because you are probably wishing all the best in the upcoming year, the whole year, not just the 1st of January, which would be the case if you wrote it with a capital N. So here is something that you would know, and not all the Czech people would know. The last day of the year is also referred to as Silvestr, because that's Silvestr's name day. And when we talk about the last day of the year, we usually refer to as Silvestr. Silvestr with a lowercase s means the last day of the year, 31. prosince, and would be related to the New Year's Eve celebration. Silvestrovská oslava, the Silvester's celebration, the New Year's celebration. So Silvestr with a capital S would be a reference to the name in the calendar. Silvestr with a lowercase s is the New Year's celebration. We can ask a very common question. Co děláš na Silvestra? What are you going to do for the New Year's Eve? Co děláš na Silvestra? With a lowercase s. In a couple of minutes, I'm going to play a very authentic dialogue between two colleagues that run into each other in a supermarket, and they are getting their shopping done for the New Year celebration, Silvestr. But first, I would like to get you acquainted with some of these phrases for a colloquial Czech, because there will be quite a few. What you will hear in the dialogue, for example, a question: Kde se tady bereš? Kde se tady bereš? You can say this when you are surprised and you see somebody. Oh. What are you doing here? Where did you come from? Kde se tady bereš? It's just another way of saying co tady děláš? What are you doing here? But it is more informal. Colloquial Czech. Kde se tady bereš? Where did you come from? Na zítra. You probably know this, that sometimes we use the combination EJ, A, and that would be the sign of colloquial Czech. So na zítra for tomorrow instead of saying na zítra. Dostala jsi něco pěkného? Did you get anything nice, anything pretty? When asking about presents. So here we have two signs of colloquial Czech. Dostala jsi, being connected with this verb. This is past tense. Pěkného. And the standard Czech would be dostala jsi něco pěkného. So this would be separate, this auxiliary verb. So those of you that know past tense would know the standard version, but when it comes to the person ty, the informal one, we can abbreviate this and just use the S. We can move the S around and put it in a certain places. We'll see another example. Dostala jsi něco pěkného versus dostala jsi něco pěkného? Next one. Měkký i tvrdý dárky. Soft and hard gifts. When we talk about soft gifts such as clothes, they might not be exciting for all the people. Tvrdý dárky, hard gifts, electronics, books, those hard gifts. And again, the colloquial Czech is in the ending. Měkký i tvrdý dárky in standard Czech is měkké i tvrdé dárky. Because this would be the plural for masculine inanimate. Dárek, a gift. Co jsi dostal ty? What did you get? Again, co jsi? This is the same example as here. So the standard Czech would be co jsi dostal ty. Again, we abbreviated this into S and then we put it here. This is not the only place where we could put it. We could also ask co dostal jsi? But usually we would keep it at the beginning. Barevné ponožky, it was referring to socks, colorful socks. Barevné, again, another example with a colloquial ending for an adjective instead of the standard Czech barevné ponožky. Barevné ponožky. Before I erase this, let's read this together. You repeat after me. Opakuj po mně. Kde se tady bereš? Na zítra. Dostala jsi něco pěkného? Měkký i tvrdý dárky. Co jsi dostal ty? Barevné ponožky. At the end of the dialogue, we will hear a lot of these exclamations or wishes. And these are all in colloquial Czech. To seš hodnej. That's kind of you. That's nice of you. To. Many times we add to and it's not really necessary. Seš. Hodnej. They're all colloquial signs. So you could say to si hodný or ty si hodný. You are kind. To seš hodný versus the standard form to si hodný, ty si hodný. Hezkýho Silvestra. Nice Silvester, nice end of the year. So Silvester here, although we talk about the celebration, we made it masculine animate. We talk about it as a person. This is an accusative case. I wish you a nice end of the year. So the endings is also for masculine animate. Hezkýho Silvestra, a colloquial Czech. Hezkého Silvestra is the standard Czech. Do novýho roku hodně zdraví. This is genitive. Do novýho. To the new year, a lot of health. We're implying that I wish you a lot of health in the new year. Do novýho roku hodně zdraví. Do nového roku hodně zdraví. And the last one, šťastný novej rok. Šťastný novej rok. That would be the colloquial version of šťastný nový rok. So you choose which you like more and which is more suitable for a situation. When you talk to a friend, it is absolutely fine and sometimes even more acceptable to use the colloquial Czech. And if you were writing or speaking publicly, you would use the standard Czech. And once again, let's read these together. Opakuj po mně. To seš hodnej. Hezkýho Silvestra. Do novýho roku hodně zdraví. Šťastný nový rok. Now let's listen to the dialogue. I am going to play it twice, first time without the English translation and the second time with it, so then you can compare how much you've understood. Jdeme na to! Let's do this!
S dovolením.
Jo, pardon. Je, Magdo, ahoj.
Zdeňku, kde se tady bereš?
To víš, nakupuju něco na zítra, na Silvestra.
Jo, jo, já taky. Budete slavit doma?
Jo, jak jinak. A vy?
No, taky doma v klidu.
A co Vánoce? Dostala jsi něco pěknýho?
Šaty a knížky, takže jsem spokojená.
Měkký i tvrdý dárky. To Ježíšek udělal dobře.
No a co jsi dostal ty? Ponožky.
Jo, ale barevný.
Já už jdu platit.
Já už mám taky hotové.
Je.
Co je?
No já asi nemám peněženku. Je asi v autě.
Já to zaplatím za tebe.
To ne.
Ale jo, vždyť mi to můžeš vrátit v pondělí v práci.
Tak dobře, to seš hodnej.
To víš, musím se snažit. No, abych příští rok dostal něco lepšího než ponožky.
Tak moc děkuju. A hezkýho Silvestra. A do novýho roku. Hodně zdraví.
I tobě. Šťastný nový rok.
S dovolením.
Jo, pardon. Je, Magdo, ahoj.
Zdeňku, kde se tady bereš?
To víš. Nakupuju něco na zítra, na Silvestra.
Jo, jo, já taky. Budete slavit doma?
Jo, jak jinak. A vy?
No, taky doma v klidu.
A co Vánoce? Dostala jsi něco pěknýho?
Šaty a knížky, takže jsem spokojená.
Měkký i tvrdý dárky. To Ježíšek udělal dobře.
No a co jsi dostal ty? Ponožky.
Jo, ale barevný.
Já už jdu platit.
Já už mám taky hotové.
Je.
Co je?
No já asi nemám peněženku. Je asi v autě.
Já to zaplatím za tebe.
To ne.
Ale jo, vždyť mi to můžeš vrátit v pondělí v práci.
Tak dobře, to seš hodnej.
To víš, musím se snažit. No abych příští rok dostal něco lepšího než ponožky.
Tak moc děkuju. A hezkýho Silvestra. A do novýho roku. Hodně zdraví.
I tobě. Šťastný nový rok.
Dámy a pánové, to je ode mě všechno. Já se s vámi loučím a přeji vám krásný nový rok. Krásný nový rok. A hodně štěstí v roce 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all from me. I'm saying goodbye. Leaving you with this wish of Happy New Year and the best of luck in the upcoming year 2022. Mějte se krásně. Ahoj!